how OneDrive works with other Microsoft products. So how does it work with SharePoint and Microsoft Teams? So I'll go on to each of these applications to show you what that looks like. From within Teams, I can actually access my OneDrive files. And to do that, I just need to go to the left side of my screen in the toolbar on the left and choose Files. And there's a couple of places in here that'll let me see my OneDrive files, one of them being under Recent. Recent shows a mixture of files. It's any file I've opened in any of the Microsoft clouds that I'm using, such as OneDrive, SharePoint, or Teams. I also have a separate cloud storage area that will be shown on the left here that says OneDrive, and you can add other storage, and you see that button there to say add cloud storage. So when I click on OneDrive here, even though I'm in Microsoft Teams, nobody else has seen these files unless I've shared them with them. Teams is not sharing these files. It's just giving me a shortcut to get to my files. And I can, as you can see, I can also even go to open in OneDrive, so it'll let me go right to OneDrive to look at these files from there. But I could also just open the file right from here. So this file I have open is open in Teams, but it is a OneDrive file. It's not a file that's shared with anybody in Teams. So I'm going to close that. And I'm going to show you another place within Teams that you can integrate OneDrive. So I'm going to go to the Teams area on the left. And I'm going to go to our performance management channel of our human resources team and go to files. And from within here, I can say add shortcut to OneDrive. So what this is allowing me to do is kind of go the opposite way. It's letting me say, I want to see these files that are in this team, but rather than having to open the team to look at the files, I just want to look at them from my OneDrive. So if I'm always looking at OneDrive, why not show me some other files there as well? So it's letting me create a shortcut from my team to OneDrive. So let's do that. I'm going to say add shortcut to OneDrive. So it says what added one shortcut to my files in OneDrive. So now I'm going to go to my files in OneDrive. Like click on that just to show you. So I'm in my files in my OneDrive, and I want you to notice performance management is a folder in my files with a little link on it. So anything with a link on it means it's not really living there. It's actually just a link to somewhere else. It's a shortcut. So in this case, it's a shortcut to the Teams files. So if I click on performance management here, it opens up the files, and these are all the files that I have. If I move this over so you can see, these are the same files that are here. If I open up any of these and change any of these, it's changing these ones. So it's just letting me get to this area quicker. So just notice as well, while we're looking at my files on OneDrive, I do have course notes and manual. So that is another link I've made previously that is not a folder that's living in OneDrive. It's actually coming from somewhere else. It's coming from one of my Microsoft Teams or SharePoint sites. Now with OneDrive open, the web app, I want you to notice on my left side here, it shows quick access. So these quick access locations either refer to a Teams site, which is also a SharePoint site, or just a SharePoint site. So all of these on the left are not OneDrive locations. So if I click on one of these, Instructors is one of my Teams, so, and it's also one of my SharePoint sites. And if you look over to the right, it says go to site. So go to site means go to the SharePoint site. So if I click on that, that's the SharePoint site. Let's go back there. So Microsoft's giving you a number of ways to access your files, whether they're shared files or whether they're the files that you have for yourself alone. So OneDrive are the files that you have for yourself alone. You're deciding whether you share those or not, but SharePoint and Teams are all shared files. And if you want to get quick access to those shared files, you have many opportunities to do so. Now let's talk about a third Microsoft application that works well with OneDrive, and that is OneNote. So if you want to make a notebook for yourself that lives on your OneDrive, then you can actually open up your OneDrive app like I have open here and go to New at the top and choose OneNote Notebook. And that'll create a notebook that lives on your OneDrive that you could choose to share with somebody else later on if you want to, but it can just be for yourself as well. And then you can access that notebook anywhere that you can access the web. So that's one way to integrate OneDrive with OneNote. Let's just go a different direction. I'm gonna open up OneNote and show you how to access OneDrive from there. So with OneNote open, if I go to File and I choose to do a new file, a new notebook really, then I do have the option on the left side here to choose OneDrive as the source that I save my notebook to. So I could either be on OneDrive, create a new notebook there, or I can be in OneNote and choose OneDrive as my location for my notebooks. So either direction. And that's how those two products work together. Best of luck and have fun using OneDrive in the best way possible.